Why is your life so interesting? You have to write your memoirs.
But see, that's exactly the question that I asked myself forever. And it's like, the world does not need another poor orphan girl to make good story in life. So why my story? And I over and over and over, I asked myself that question. Why do this now? And a friend of mine said, you know, Nell, you almost never talk about yourself. You never talk about yourself. And she said, you have lots of interesting things to share. And I think people would get value out of what the things that you have experienced. And you've had an interesting life. I mean, I talk about my lamp over here, the title of the book, Cracked Glass. And there's all kinds of things that you go through to make a lamp as beautiful as that. But the last part that they do is that they put the clear stuff over the glass. And I feel like the last 5 years of my life have been a willingness on my part to be transparent about what has happened in my life, to share those stories that help make me into the person that I am today, because I think that I'm so ordinary. I'm just a regular person. Now, by coincidence, I've had a lot of names, and I love to play with that idea. And so when I did a therapy workshop one time, the therapist said, wow, that was really powerful work you did. And I said, that wasn't even the name I grew up with. And she looked at me and her jaw dropped down and she said, what do you mean that wasn't your name? I said, oh, no, no. I said, all those events occurred when I was Darlene Pauly. And she said, how many names have you had? And I said, oh, I've my fourth, you know, I've had four names. She said, the next time you come to one of these workshops, I want you to have a name tag on for every one of the people you have been in your life. So, you know, I get to laugh about it. I get to entertain about it. But it was a journey through all of that until I came to pick Nell and Rose. And they were very carefully chosen words. And I realized that that's really who I am in this world. And then when I moved to California, I became a minister. And then that's my fifth legal name. So I'm kind of Nell Rose, and I've chosen to my memoir to be the name that I am. So this is a memoir by Nell Rose. I'm having fun with it. I'm writing the hard stuff. I'm a little scared about being so transparent about myself. I told a friend, I said, listen, I'm not putting every detail out there, but I'm putting a lot out there. And he said, well, people will just realize you're part of the human race, that's all. So, and friends keep assuring me, Nell, you have to promise us you will finish this book because it's going to touch people. You know, the kinds of things that you have been through, what you have learned, and your ability to communicate with that can be very powerful and help make a difference in people's lives. And that's what I'm aiming for, is to give some comfort, some support, some insight, and a good read to one ordinary woman's journey through life.